Hello everybody, in this video I'm going to show you how to fix the DirectX error for Warzone and Call of Duty Black Ops 6. If you're interested in that, watch the rest of the video and try not to skip any steps. The first thing you want to try is to downgrade your GPU drivers. A lot of people have said that this fixes the issue for them. So if you're on AMD or NVIDIA, you want to go to the website and locate and download an older, more stable driver or a beta driver that hasn't been released yet either way. And in order to uninstall it, press the Windows button plus X, choose the device manager, go into display adapters, and from here you can uninstall the driver. Alternatively, you can use a tool like display driver uninstaller right here, DDU. This is a free tool. If you Google it and download it, this will work as well. And that would be the first step. The second step is try to run the game in DirectX 11. I'm going to show you how to do this in both Steam and Xbox Game Pass. For Steam, it's very easy. You just open Steam. You go to the game, you right click on it, hit properties. And under launch options, type in this hyphen DX11. Now for Xbox Game Pass, it's a little bit more complicated, but basically you want to open up Xbox Game Pass, right click on the game that you want to run, go to manage, go to files, go to browse, find Call of Duty, find content. And so basically there is no good way of doing that in Windows 11 anyway. So what you need to do is go to search, go to CMD, command prompt. You want to take this file path and say CD that file path. It will bring you to this file path. And you have this file right here called bootstrapper.exe. And then you want to type in after this E3D11. And this will launch Call of Duty in DirectX 11. And this will solve the DirectX issue for a lot of people. Right now, I did it this way. Through Xbox Game Pass, but your file path might be different. So yeah, just take the file path that you got from Xbox Game Pass and find bootstrapper, not COD.exe. The next thing you want to do is try to repair the game. And in Xbox Game Pass, again, that's very easy. Right click on it, click manage, click files, click verify and repair. If you're in Windows, you can go to settings, apps, installed apps, look for Call of Duty or Warzone or whatever it might be, click on advanced options, and click on repair and reset. Now Steam is very similar. You just right click on the game, you click on properties, you click on installed files, and you click on verify integrity of demo files. Now the next step that you might want to consider is disable overclocking. If you have overclocking software, such as MSI Afterburner or ASUS GPU Tweak, you want to reset the GPU and CPU clocks to default values and then relaunch the game. Another thing that has been working for some people is to underclock your RAM. So you want to restart your PC and open your BIOS menu manually. This is usually F2, F10, or delete when you're booting. Navigate to the RAM settings under advanced or memory section and reduce the frequency to 3500 megahertz if you're running at 4000 megahertz or higher. Save the changes and exit the BIOS. Unfortunately, I can't capture my screen while I'm doing this. But this sounds harder than it is. Just go to the BIOS and reduce the RAM speed just a little bit. This will not really reduce the speed of the game, not visually anyway. The game will run just fine. But for some reason, the RAM speed is a big issue when getting DirectX errors. And again, I've talked about this in other videos, but what you want to do is reduce the VRAM usage within the game as well. And you want to adjust the target usage to about 50 to 75% of your GPU's available VRAM. So for example, if your GPU has 8 gigabytes of VRAM, set the target to 4 gigabytes of VRAM, save the settings, and restart the game. Okay, when you're in this menu, click on the settings icon, go to graphics. Here, you'll see the display settings right here. You want to go into... Well, first of all, you want to click on shaders preloading. This is an issue for a lot of people. And you want to go into quality. And it has a VRAM scale target right here. It shows right here how much it is running. This is how much RAM I have. I'm setting the target to 70. You might want to try lowering this to 50 or something like that. But again, you might not be able to even get to the screen if you're having DirectX errors. And for the other steps, you want to remove background applications, of course. So any kind of applications like Discord, GeForce Experience, or anything like that, you want to open Task Manager, Control, Shift, and Escape, and look for any resource background heavy programs. So let's open it here. You can sort it by memory. I have VTube Studio running, but you can close any kind of memory heavy intensive programs, and that will solve some issues. And the last step you might want to try is to restart your PC, enter the BIOS, locate the XMP profile setting. This should be under the memory or advanced section, and disable XMP to use the default RAM timings. Save the changes and exit the BIOS. Again, I can't show my screen doing this, but this is something you should definitely try. So it seems like the DirectX error is mostly linked to memory issues within Windows, and by fixing these memory issues, you will no longer have the error. So if this video helped you or if it solved your problem, please leave the video a like. And if you still have the problem, leave the video a comment and I will do my best to get back to you.